Sunday Dech is one of four current NBL players who have jumped through hoops to represent South Sudan. The basketball squad of the world's youngest country set to make games history, becoming the first team to represent the nation at Olympic level.
The road from community courts to Paris hasn't been easy for South Sudan or Perth Rhino Basketball Academy alumni Sunday Dech.
I think our journey so far has been nothing short of a miracle. So to be out there, we've got nothing to lose.
The academy a breeding ground for South Sudanese basketball talent, but Dech's on-court future wasn't always so certain.
I think at 12 I had aspirations of playing AFL footy, so basketball wasn't even on the radar.
Otherwise known as the Bright Stars, they dazzled the basketball world last year, locking in their game's debut after becoming the highest-ranked African nation in their first ever World Cup.
Oh, it feels like a lifetime ago, you know. But no, the emotions were raw, they were genuine, and I think it was something that we didn't really think could happen in this shorter time frame.
Dech and the rest of the squad looking to build on the foundation laid 11 years ago when the country joined the international circuit.
I'll be ready, whatever the opportunity presents itself, whether it's, you know, guarding Steph Curry, LeBron or KD. Whichever one, I think it's going to be something I'll cherish.
Top Olympic seeds on notice after the world number 33 pushed the reigning gold medalist USA to the final buzzer in a pre-games friendly.
We're going to go out there, follow our game plan, and, you know, we're there, we deserve to be there, and we're going to give it our best shot.
The next generation of Rhinos, currently coached by Dech's brother, won't be the only ones keeping a keen eye on their hometown heroes.
You know, there are 64 tribes in South Sudan, and, you know, when that ball goes up, you forget about the tribalism, you forget about everything else that goes on around the country, that we just sort of focus on looking at that flag being represented.
James Broadhurst for 10 News First.